this new tutorial, and today we are going to install EmguCV 4.x.x, which means you can install any of the versions of the EmguCV, and the easiest way to install is through Nuget package. So let us try with Nuget package. The first thing that you need to go to the website and check, go to EmguCV and find out that if you have what is the latest version of OpenCV wrapper that EmguCV, and you can see that the stable version is 4.1.1. Let us go and create a new project, and since this is my Visual Studio 2019, so I am going to select the C#, and you can also select the desktop. So, or you can search for Windows Forms. So, and there are two options available, with the .NET framework, or you can create with the .NET Core. So I'm just creating the Windows Forms application with the .NET framework. And then the framework that I'm just selecting is 4.7, and then I click on the create button. So this application will be created, and the first thing that we need to do is to add the EmguCV library. So we can right click on this project, go to manage Nuget packages, go to the browse, and here we can write EmguCV space CV. I'm just downloading this CPU version, so if you are interested in working with the CUDA, then you should be installing this CUDA. So I'm going to go ahead and install it, and then click on this accept. So you can see that in the output there is the Open EmguCV has been successfully installed. So that's it. We can test it if it is successfully installed or not. Let me drag and drop a button, and just I name it load image, and I can also drag and drop a picture box here, and in this picture box I'm just going to show an image, and maybe I can also change it to the zoom if my image is bigger or smaller, so that it can fit inside my picture box depending on whatever it is. Double click on this button, and the first thing that we need to do is to reference the EmguCV library here. So emgu.cv, so this contains some of the core classes that we need to use, and also emgucv.cv.structure. This is the basic data structures have already been defined in this structure namespace. So the first thing that I need to do inside my class is, let me define some references for my objects. So let me say that I am going to read a blue-green color image with blue, green, and red order, and it has the depth of time byte. So I am assuming that the maximum value that can have is between 0 and 255. So let me open a file dialog. I just call it dialog, and let us create an object of the open file dialog. And once I create the object of the file dialog, I can show it, and to make sure that dialog.showDialog, and in order to make sure that the user has selected an image to read, so I'm just making sure that the data has been selected, the path has been selected, and the user pressed OK. Once the image has been selected, we can read it. So I'm just saying img input is equal to new input, and in the constructor I can pass, you can see the a file name as well. So this file name I can select from the file name, and once we read this image, we can show it in the picture box one which we have selected. Dot image is equal to img input dot bitmap because it is expecting some bitmap image. So let us run this application and see if we have successfully installed our EmguCV 4xx or not. So let us click on load image. So from here I'm going to select an image and let's say we want to display this image, and it is working fine. So this is the easiest way to install EmguCV in .NET framework.